You're talking about this period of 2012, 14, and I have the feeling that it was over. And I think that the project of Non-Aligned Utopia came also from that feeling that from 2014 and 15, the digital scene was mainly led by the startup scene and the Silicon Valley mythology. The fact that Facebook, Google went massively on the continent, and they have programmed also with quite a lot of money to develop the startup scene. And it was kind of jump from the artistic and more experimental exploration of net art and digital art to a more entrepreneur way of developing the digital on the continent. And that's the first point. It was to react on that overwhelming of massive discourse around the capacity of the startup to develop a new project, to be able to invent from scratch, and looking for the next Steve Jobs model on the continent. And on the other side of the project, there was the book of Felwine Sarr called Afrotopia, who was pointing the fact that the description of the continent was maybe too shiny or too dark, and that if the continent wanted to go beyond and have the own model of development, we would have to invent our own metaphor for the future. So regarding those two those two points, the idea of non-aligned utopia was also to say that but there is people on the continent that use digital technology, that are trained for digital technology, but they don't want to develop only the Silicon Valley way of development. So we worked with Kurtjesan, which is also a kind of non-aligned or a third place for the digital to develop this this project. And I don't know if yes, I have to add that immediately. Non-alignment was in echo to the non-historical non-aligned movement that emerged in the 50s, where the so-called underdeveloped countries reacted and didn't want to align neither on the West nor on the communist bloc, and were also reclaiming value like collaboration, cooperation, being more aware or being more focused on what could lead to an emancipatory processes. Voilà, that's I think the main frame for this for the theme and the way we have tried to develop it in Dakar. François has really used this as a starting point for his project, trying to find if there is utopia, potential utopia in the digital. And I think it's interesting maybe in the conversation to explore the potentiality of utopia in the digital.